Well, I think the best way to protect the humanities in this digital age is to make sure that everyone knows, make sure that every young person in Britain knows what the humanities means to their lives. And to go back to your original question of what would life be like without the humanities, perhaps the humanities needs to conceptualize that philosophically, yeah, and see just how barren, yeah, and what a dull world it would be without the critically incisive work of scholars who study the humanities.
I think it's really important for us to protect the humanities by doing events like we've done tonight, by engaging students with them in universities, by talking to the public, by getting people interested and involved in thinking about how important the humanities are in helping us understand ourselves.
To protect the humanities, I think we need to recognise the sort of special quality that is a form of intellectual curiosity, a form of intellectual endeavour that serves its own ends. We shouldn't be looking to defend the humanities on the basis of the money it can produce or how it can contribute a sort of financial wealth. I think that's probably losing the battle before we've won. We should be thinking about what it gives us beyond that kind of instrumentalised view.